Hi friends, welcome to Learn Electronics channel. In this video, we will understand electrical switches. So there are varieties of electrical switches. We will understand and classify them. The most basic or elementary component used in electronics is a switch. Switches operations are very simple. You don't need any complex equations or mathematics to understand these switches. All these switches are used to open or close the circuit. They need an external stimulus such as a press or force to open or close the circuit. Remember, the door of a house is a very good example for a working operation of a switch. The switch can exist only one of the two states. The one state is open and the second one is closed. Now refer the below circuit diagram. In this case, the first diagram, say when the switch is off or switch is open, the current cannot flow and LED is switched off. When refer the second diagram, here what happens is the switch is pressed on. So the switch is on now, the circuit is closed, now current flows, LED is on. There are varieties of switches, and firstly they can be classified based on how they are operated. So for example, on the method of operation, if you look at it, so for switch to be on to off, you need to press it. So when you push it, then this switch type of switches are called as push button. If you are sliding them, these switches are called slide switches. And similarly, there are any physical action you take, this when mechanical linkages of this switch acts upon, such as pulling, key turning, heating, magnetizing, all these type of operations, they can be classified into. Based on how these switches are to be mounted on a PCB, on THD, SMD or breadboard or chassis, the switches can be classified. Now in the THD type, that is through hole type switches, they have a bigger leads so that they are inserted in a PCB and they are soldered. When you look at the SMT type switches are much smaller than THD type switches. And if you see in the figure, you have a gullwing type of leads, and these leads are very small. And when you look at the chassis mounting type of switches, these switches are much bigger in size and they have an option to fix on the chassis, and they have indicators also sometimes. And the other type, the breadboard mounting type of switches, they are in the form of dual in line packages and their leads are easy to connect on the breadboard. Most of the switches fall into one of these categories: momentary or maintained. Momentary switches, when you press them, during that duration they are on, and when you leave them, they are off. Push button is a very good example for momentary switches, but all push buttons are of not of the type momentary. Similarly, the maintained switches, what when you press them, okay, they will be on, and they are on until a next press. Similarly, but rocker switch is a very good example for the maintained switches, but all rocker switches are not maintained switches. The switches have poles and throws. The pole denotes the number of separate circuit a switch can control. For example, a one pole switch can control one circuit. Two pole switch can control two circuits. Similarly, throw denotes the number of positions each of the switches pole can be connected. For example, in one pole, one throw, you can see one circuit can be controlled for one position. Similarly, for one pole, two throw, one circuit you can control two positions. Based on this, you can classify them as SPST, single pole, single throw. You can see there one pole for one position you can control in this switch. Similarly, in SPDT, we have one pole and two throws. That means one circuit can be controlled for two positions. In DPDT, for example, that is a dual pole, dual throw. In this you have two poles and four positions. In one pole you have two throws and the other pole you have two throws. That means you can control two circuits for two positions. Similarly, in DPST, that is dual pole single throw, for each of the pole you have a single throw. That means you can switch on two circuits for a single position. Or most of these switches falls into category of either normally open or closed, NMO or NC. Switch is when it is not operated, it is not in the normal state of the switch. See, for example, in SPST switch, the switch is normally open. That means you need to press it to get it on. Similarly, in SPDT, the one position it is on, you need to press it for the other position. And if you take another DPST example, there are two circuits. So both the circuits are off. When you press it on, both it is connected. Similarly, you take an example of DPDT. There are two circuits and they are one for one position. When you press it, they will change the position to second position. Similarly, there are varieties of switches based on the action, such as pulling, key turning, heating, magnetizing, door opening and all. You need to choose these type of switches for based on your application. Here I have some of the types of switches based on the action. You have anti-vandal switches, detector switches, dip switches, rotary switches, navigation switches, push buttons, rockers and a toggle switch. These are few of the types, still more they are available. In addition to this, there are some switches, for example, electronic switches and actuator type switches, a light type of switches. These are other types of switches and there are some special switches also. So I will have covered few of the types of switches, but I could able to cover few more in my further videos.